Vito, they fucked me up pretty good. I think I need a doctor.
Okay, let's get you over to El Greco.
The painted? Other places, that? Let's cook something temporary. Shit. Come on, Jara.
My chest. Every time I breathe, they broke my damn ribs.
Take it easy. El Greco's gonna fix you up.
Yeah. Sure. fuck. Every time I cough, it feels like I'm being stabbed
Sounds
in the chest.
Definitely like a broken
rib. The more you whine about it, the worse it's gonna be.
Listen, Vito. Thanks for coming after me. And almost getting yourself killed.
Hey, we're in this together, right? Just like always. Now just sit the fuck back before you get blood all over my pants and I really do stab in your chest.
Oh, you picked a hell of a time to turn into a fucking comedian.
El Greco, yes.
She means the world to you. So why not show your gal that you care with a beautiful diamond pendant necklace from Goldman Jewelers? Or our exclusive honeydew golden bracelet. It's only $4.95 while supplies last, and it's only at Goldman Jewelers, Empire Bay's number one jewelry store. When you want to show her you truly care,
well, at least rather than
Goldman Jewelers.
Loose Joe. That would be too much. We're almost at the bottom of the hill.
Alley, ice wagon blue, hit a bump and somebody screamed. You should have heard just what I see. Who do you love? Who do you love? Who do you love?
Then we have to smash this. Or nice.
Need a hand?
I can make it.
What do you want me to do with the money?
Take it to Bruno.
All right. At least that'll be out of the way.
Good evening, gentlemen. Oh, what happened to you?
Hey, Doc. I got my ass kicked and I'm coughing up
what
blood.
What is happening today? One of your guys is already here. His name is Antonio Balsamo.
Tony Balls? What happened to him?
Somebody messed him up pretty good. I don't think he's ever going to walk again.
What?
This surprises you? All the blood, all the death. This is the lifestyle you choose. One day your luck is bound
that's
to run
the
out.
Guy from Barnes
next
and
time, it could be
enough with the sermon, Doc.
Chapter.
Joe?
Yes, but you'll have to wait a minute while I fix Antonio up.
That's okay, Doc.
All right, come in.
Make sure you settle things with Bruno, okay? And Vito. Thanks.
Sure thing. Feel better.
Okay. Let's hit a diner on our way there.
Delta Radio. It's the old disc jockey slash news commentator slamming Sammy Stevens bringing you news from Midtown. Construction site carnage. That's what the papers might call it tomorrow. Witnesses have reported the sound of... It's safe to say that if you see some flashing lights coming from behind you, pull over and duck, baby. For EDLT Radio, I'm slamming Sammy Stevens.
How long am I on the street minding my own affairs? When two policemen grabbed me, unaware.
Time to pull.
They said, is your name Henry? I said, oh, why, sure.
And see?
They said,
that's
you the
next.
Boy we've been looking for.
Shit. Lucky bastard. Oh, you're stuck in a traffic jam.
Subject is about 6 feet tall, average size. 10-4.
This should be enough to get a coffee and fix my car. Game can be very GTA-ish. Mona Lisa, no shit. If you're in the mood for it. Nice. Actually, I don't blame them for not opening the place for me. How much I need.
Making your feet move and your soul shine. Delta Radio, EDLT, Empire Bank.
Yo, Vito, how's it going?
Yeah. Yes.
Just tell me what you need, sir.
That's a bit expensive. I think it's actually cheaper. Hell, if I do it. Nah, we'll afford it.
All fixed. Good as new.
I've got 400. Thanks, Vito.
Appreciate
left.
The business.
Don't. Shit. Fuck. Is it damaged?
Good evening, Mr. Skeletta. So what can I do for you, sir? Thanks, Vito. Appreciate the business.
What? This can't be right. Yeah, now we are low on fuel. Shit. Might as well rob this place also.
Evening, mister.
Full tank, please.
Sure thing.
Full tank and your life.
Alright. Almost done there, boss. We'll be back on the road in no time. Is that everything, sir?
Thank you.
Thanks for stopping in, sir.
Yeah. Now, let's position the car for the getaway. Too late, Mr. Policeman. Put your gun in my heart with left headphones. I take my baby away from home. Forgot about visiting the bar. Well, I don't like this coat anyway. Okay, I'm moving,
DLT, Delta Radio. Don't touch that dial.
Gonna wait for the cops to leave.
Unfortunately, those words, once merely the subject matter of comic books and Saturday matinees, are appearing.
Hello, sir. Come in.
Headlines in our newspapers. I'm Gary Stevens with breaking news on ECLA. Violence once again reared its ugly head today at a construction site in Midtown.
Let's take the blue van.
In a deadly shootout at the incomplete structure before police arrived on the scene.
We got a homicide here. Suspect is armed. 10-4.
Resolve. For ECLA, I'm Gary Stevens.
Suspect is about 6 feet tall, average size.
Roger that.
Officer down! Officer down! Shoot this asshole!
10-4.
Shit. Clear. Shit, did I shoot at my own window? Let's just take care of them. I'm not gonna go far with a tire like that.
Hey, I need to see Bruno.
Got the money?
Yeah.
Come on in then. You're lucky. We were just about to leave.
Good evening. You have the money for me? Or do you wish to extend?
The blue one also looks like shit.
I have to admit, this is somewhat of a surprise. I heard you boys had some complications.
Yeah, we did.
I heard that Henry is dead.
Yeah.
I'm sorry to hear that. Isaac, count it. So your little business venture was a success?
You got your money, right?
Right, right. It's just that the whole city has been turned upside down. The Chinese think the Italians attacked them, so they're going after Vinci. That's not good. Not good. Would that have anything to do with the reason you borrowed this money?
Sorry, Bruno. That's none of your business.
Thank you, Isaac. It looks like the debt is settled. I don't even know your name.
Vito.
Vito who?
Vito Scaletta.
Scaletta. I knew a Scaletta once. But I must say, you're much better at paying back your debts than he was. His poor wife had to do it for him.
So it was you who lent my father the money?
Your father. Like father, like son. I see you don't approve. But I didn't make him borrow the money, now did I? Just like I didn't make you. If you ever need a loan, you know where to find me.
Sure.